everybody. I'm Marty Fleischman, and with me, Kevin Koffman. We're here at the beautiful Tampa High Life Fronton in Tampa, Florida, to fill you in on all the action on Partido 4, the best of five series at the World High Life Tournament of Champions. They're playing for some big prize money, $18,000 in total prize money, and the prestige of winning this major inner-city event. Kevin, you've been on hand for all three partidos we've had so far, and this third partido that was in Miami last week was probably something different that the fans didn't see the first two partidos. Tell us about the difference in that partido.
Well, Marty, going into partido number three, I think everyone, after viewing the first two partidos, didn't give the Tampa team of Echeva and Arrigo much of a chance. The first two partidos had been dominated by Joey and Cirola, totally dominated, really. The Tampa team, Echeva and Arrigo, had played well, but the Miami team had played better. Going into the third partido at the Miami High Life Fronton, the home court, everyone was really expecting the Tournament of Champions trophy to stay right there in Miami and for everything to be wrapped up. As it turned out, it didn't work out that way. The Miami team, Joey and Cirola, didn't play up to par in partido number three, and the Tampa team was up to the challenge. Echeva in the front court for Tampa played flawlessly, made no mistakes, dropped no balls, and the Tampa team picked up a convincing 15-10 victory. Strategy in that third partido came really into play. The Miami team during the first two partidos had managed to keep the ball on Arrigo, the backcourt for Tampa's men, on the reverse. And Arrigo, being a 35-year-old player, a little bit tiring maybe in the late stages of a partido, he got tired in partidos one and two, and I think that the Miami team didn't take advantage of that in partido number three. It remains to see whether strategy comes into play and whether the Tampa team can make this tournament go to five partidos.
Nobody thought we were going to be here in Tampa. We thought it was going to be over in three straight. It's come to the fourth partido. There's tension in the air at the Tampa Fronton. More than 3,500 fans will be here tonight after the 12th game to see this action. To bring you up to date, though, the partido action in the World Highlight Tournament of Champions started in 1976. And since then, we've had the series split. Now 2-2, then Miami won last year 3-2. Let's review the action from 1977 to the present. In 1977, a 21-year-old American player named Joey Cornblit qualified for the Miami team with a big backcourter named Marcoita. Defending champion Bolivar, playing with backcourter Honor Buttery for Tampa, seen here in the red jerseys, were trying to make it two in a row. There was already a rivalry being established between the Tampa and Miami front quarters, and this match brought them head-to-head for the first time. Joey was noted for his Ramate kill shot, Bolivar for his overwhelming power. Here, Joey tries his Ramate inside on Bolivar, but Bolivar answers with his own powerful kill shot to let Joey know that he was indeed the champion. Joey began to find the range, and the Tampa team fell in three straight. The Tournament of Champions trophy, prominently displayed in Miami, Tampa was seeking revenge. Joey, trying for a second win in a row and teamed with a veteran backcourter, Enrique, faced another future superstar, Tampa's Echeva, who was teamed with a great backcourter, Noronha. Joey, here in red, tested young Echeva early, and the Tampa frontcourter responded with an aggressiveness that Joey would remember. Though the first partido of the series was won by Miami in a close 15-14 battle, Joey and Enrique began to exploit Echeva's lack of experience. The series ended with a frustrated Echeva and the trophy still resting in Miami. Jesus Elejabrieta and Rafael Garonio began playing highlight together as children in their hometown of Durango, Spain. When they qualified to represent Tampa in 1979, the fans knew the veterans from Durango had the best shot for bringing the title back to the Cigar City. In this, the final partido, going against Miami's Uriarte and Pierre, who are in the red jerseys of post one, Jesus and Garonio demonstrated that there is more to Jai-Alai than just speeding pelotas. While the young Uriarte thought his skills were enough, and the Frenchman Pierre played exceptionally well, nothing replaces that uncanny instinct the team developed from years of experience. Jesus and Garonio defeated the Miami team in four partidos. Tampa had now put the overall series between the two cities even. In 1980, Miami fielded a team of two giants, 6'3" seats, tallest front court in the world, and Soroa, who in stretching the Cessna to make a catch seems to be 10 feet tall. Returning for Tampa was Jesus, teamed with his own giant back man, 6'6" Zulaika II, seen here in the blue shirts of post two. Jesus, being only 5'5", is known in Spain as David the Giant Killer, as he slew opponent after opponent with his quick step down. With the series tied at two games apiece, in the fifth and final partido, the end came for Tampa when Soroa threw a long carom to climax a 15-5 drubbing of the Tampa team. Jesus the Giant Killer would slay no giants that night. Watching player manager Alfredo Garcia run onto the court in his excitement show the importance of this intercity tournament. When Joey and Soroa faced Tampa, Zacheva, and Arrigo in Partido 1, there was uncertainty about how good the Tampa team really was. Joey in red immediately went to his famous remate shot against the improved Zacheva and found him waiting for it. After receiving a tip from one of his fellow Miami players that Zacheva was guarding the outside of the court, Joey began a series of inside placement shots that caught the Tampa team with nobody home. Finally, Zacheva, having been forced inside by three straight placements, was caught in this perfectly thrown two-wall rebote shot, which carried the Miami team to a 15-9 home victory. Partido 2, played in Tampa, saw Joey using the same strategy. However, Arrigo, in the blue shirt of post 2, had a few tricks up his sleeve as he scored with a surprise long carom from the backcourt. Midway through the match, that which is most feared in the sport of Jai-Alai happened. Joey was struck with a direct hit by the ball traveling in excess of 150 miles per hour. Fortunately, the impact of the ball was cushioned as it hit half on Joey's hip pad. Unshaken by the close call, the Miami team went on to defeat Tampa 15-10 for a 2-0 lead in the series and a must-win situation for Tampa. Partido 3, played in Miami, turned out to be a nightmare for the hometown favorites. Joey and Soroa, having played near flawless Jai-Alai in the past matches, were plagued by mistakes. Seen here in the red shirts of post one, Joey and Soroa never seemed to get their feet on the ground. As Tampa streaked to an early lead, Joey had to take to the offense. But when Joey threw his first remate shot of the partido, Tampa's Zacheva seemed to read his mind. Zacheva's return carom shot was perfect and had the Miami team running for their lives. One of the Miami team's strong points was communication. But this night, the American and the Basque were speaking two different languages. With a score of 14-10, in favor of Tampa, Zacheva decided to gamble with Joey's serve. His low and hard shot split the middle and sealed the victory for Tampa. While some wins are sweet, Irigo's display of happiness showed that this indeed was the sweetest. Tampa now down 2-1, brings the match to their home court and will again attempt to stay alive.